Now that we have this recursive formulation, we're ready to develop the algorithm. Let's convince ourselves first that the recursive formulation would indeed involve some needless recomputation. Take the two top-level partitions, ABC times DE on the one hand, and ABCD times E on the other. Clearly, we will have to compute the minimum cost of multiplying ABC in the left problem, but we are also going to have to compute it on the right as well, since we need to pull D off from this chain at some point. And we end up doing all the work involved in figuring out how best to multiply ABC over again. Fortunately for us, there are only n choose 2 subproblems, so we can create a table and do the subproblems in the right order. The entries along the diagonal are the base cases, which have cost 0. The product of one matrix doesn't cost anything. And our goal is to compute this value in the corner here, C1 through n, the cost of multiplying matrices A1 through AN. Consider which subproblems this depends on. When k equals 1, we're considering these costs here, C11 and C2n. When k equals 2, we're considering these problems here, C12 and C3n. When k equals 3, we consider these, and so forth. In general, every entry depends on all the elements to the left and downwards of it. There are many ways to linearize this DAG of dependence, but the most elegant is to fill out the diagonals moving towards the corner, like this. We'll let S indicate which diagonal we're working on. And then we will fill in the diagonal entry by entry from row 1 as far as it goes. For this row and diagonal, the column J will be equal to I plus S. And we compute the entry in the table as the minimum of all the possible splits of the subtree. The last step, of course, is just to return this final cost. The binary tree that produced this cost can be reconstructed from the k that were chosen that yielded these minimum values. We just need to remember the split that we used for each entry in the table.